Hello everybody, Jerome Wright here, and once again you're joining me on my Jerome Wright YouTube channel. All right, in this video I'm going to be discussing the African image, specifically what we have up here in front of us with this young woman and being disfigured. I can recall as a kid when I was growing up and I got a chance to witness my first images of what people looked like in the African culture, and I would say to myself, my God, why would a person disfigure themselves in such a way? And I couldn't imagine or grasp the reality on why anyone or they would do this to themselves, or why anyone would accept this, being that, you know, of course, that I grew up in an American way. But in any event, what happened is that, you know, I never accepted this. I never accepted this look. And I can remember that the first description that I have of why they disfigured themselves like this, people would say that they did it because of the slave trade, and they would disfigure themselves so the people that came to shepherdize them and take them away in the slave trade, they would be passed over for this look because of the way they looked. Now, that made a lot of sense to me, and that was the only reason why I actually accepted this, because I said, you know what, you know, that makes sense to me. That, I mean, if you don't want to be taken away from your home and away from your family, you disfigure yourself and you scare off or ward off your enemy that was trying to take you away. As I was surfing online for explanations, now that I'm drawn to this, I actually went and seen an explanation that this doesn't make no sense to me. They said that these people do this because, especially the women, because of their, to show that they have come into puberty and they are ready to be married. This is what this is describing. Again, people, you know that this does not make no sense. No one would disfigure themselves in such a way, morally, without significance, if there wasn't something underlined and deep and rooted to this. The reason why they disfigure themselves like this is because they are doing so to signify the creatures that they have evolved from, they have mutated from. This young lady, via, she may not know it herself, but through a gene pool of the creatures that she was created through, mentally she has the information in her mind, her tribe has the information in their minds of the creatures that they evolved through, and subconsciously what they are doing are they are creating themselves to look like the creatures from which they mutated through. You see tusk, you see the lips elongated. It's my position that they are saying this is, she is mimicking. Here, this is like an antelope or some type of deer. Antlers here, off to the side. It's my position that here, these elongated lips are trying to create the trunk and the tusk of an elephant. Even the ears, it creates the long flapping ears of the elephant. Her earrings are mimicking the flapping ears of an elephant. This young lady subconsciously has accepted the culture of disfiguring herself because mentally, that creature that dwells in her mind, these creatures that we evolved through, they have abducted our minds and our bodies in a way that they can show through and shine through of who the outside person truly is, if that makes sense to you. Look at this woman. No one would ever tell you that she is mimicking, that she is a extended byproduct, gene pooled from an elephant. But now that I'm telling you this, you can look at her and see it and attach it to Michael Jackson. on Michael Jackson's Dangerous album, cover album, right here. A similar face of this woman appears. There's a cluster of animals here. There's rhinos, there's like a peacock, there's the elephant there. Eye, if you look close, the eye can be realized either in here or there's an eyelash right there, a closed eye, and you'll see the eyelash in there. The entire face, I'm going to hold it up close so you can get a good picture there. So if you Google the image and turn it up like this here, I trust me, there is a face that is just like this. And the description of everything that I told you about the elephant being involved in the cause for the genetic change of these people. So you see, Africans were the first to be bridged over through with these animals to change the genetic identity of mankind's being, which subsequently calls for all different cultures and civilizations of people today. And they did it through the gene pool of animals. And this is what this is describing in Africa. So when you see this, and then in the Maya culture, where you see chickens and birds on people's heads, you know what they are telling you? That through the genes of those creatures, they genetically altered themselves through cells of these creatures. And calls for their genetic change. That's what this woman is describing. This is not about puberty. This is everything that I've just described to you. She may not know it, but going back in her ancient, somewhere along the line, the knowledge of all of this was suppressed. I gotta go because my video is going to run out. But go to Michael Jackson. Right here, and turn it up, and you'll see her face. Look at the lips, and the face is in there. I'm going to put more in writing. I got to go because I'm out of time. Because they are tapping into the ancient gene pool from which these beings were mutated from through the varying animals. And this is why there is such a interest in Africa. Everybody was saying the diamonds. Oh, no, no, no. That comes second to an ancient gene pool that everybody is after. The family genes of Africa. This is what everyone is occupying Africa for. This is what everything is about. When I started taking my blood pressure on my own, now, mind you, we all have went to school, had our blood pressures taken. We went to the doctors and had our blood pressure taken. Some of us at the hospitals, but some are just stick our arms in the machines that are in the, readily in all of the stores and pharmacies today, and you take your blood. We normally only put either our strongest arm in or our weakest arm in that machine. We only put one arm in that machine to have our blood pressure taken. But what people do not realize is that you could get a false reading. And what I mean by a false reading is that in your right arm, you can get one reading. And then in your left arm, you can get entirely a different reading. And there's an indicator that if these readings vary from 10 points of each other, there could be something severely wrong on one part of your body as opposed to the other. So if you're taking a reading on the good part of your body, let's say the normal reading, a part of me, let's say it's 120 over 73 on this side, you would look at that as being in the realms of being normal because 120 and below is good, and below 80, 120 over 80 is or below is supposedly a good reading. So if you get that over here, you're okay. But what you don't know, and this is on the right, this is on your right side, but what you don't know is that on the left side of your body, you could have a reading that is above the normal. You could be getting a reading over here if you took it, because most of us don't take it. You could be running a high blood pressure on this arm, on this side of your body, and not on this side. This is what I'm stating. So imagine you feeling ill. You go to the hospital. You know that something is wrong with your body. And you go there, and just like clockwork, you stick your arm out, unbeknownst to you. You stick an arm out, and they don't ask for both of your arms. They only ask for one. And fate has it that you stick out the arm that you're going to get a good reading on. And when they take your blood pressure, you give them a reading. The reading comes in 116 over 69. And you're good. But fate has it that on this side of your body, had you would have put this arm out, what you went to the hospital for, what you went to the doctor complaining for about these ill feelings that you've been having, would have been detected had they would have took the blood pressure reading in this arm. Because if they would have, you would have stuck this arm in, then you would have got a reading of, let's just say, you would have got a reading of 190 over 140. Yes, people, it is possible for your body, which is two halves together, it is possible for this side of your body to be malfunctioning while this side of your body is functioning properly.
But now they're going to make a better one. They're making a better version now. That's what the Human Genome Project is about. It's about them making a better, updated human vessel, and that's it. And then eventually, that's going to phase out because they're going to make it more cyborg. The evolution chart is sort of like incomplete. They always want you to focus on one, the monkey, when it's more. It's the makeup of the animal kingdom that the humans come from. That's one of the main reasons you would hear certain humans, they'd be like, I just had a passion to fly. Because they're expressing the bird genes. Or, I just had a passion to swim. They're expressing the fish genes. I don't know what it was, but I just feel like climbing rocks. You got that damn goat gene inside you.
The most damaging attack on African health is the promotion of albino domesticated animals for consumption. In fact, only albino animals are considered domesticated. The yellow pigment in chicken and the lack of tyrannosase in albino animals are responsible for premature aging. Illustrates the curative properties of negative ions in the electromagnetic energy of mental concentration can be directed through the breath of life by a competent psychic healer. The laying of hands on which is known to emit energy from the aura.
You know, that holds the bundle together. It's made up of 32 discs. And at the 33rd point is where your spinal column meets the base of your brain, where your pineal gland lies. This is why they say Jesus Christ died at the age of 33 in Golgotha, the place of the skull. It's all metaphysics, you know? So, you know, a lot of y'all who throw the Bible away, a lot of you don't even understand the book. So, you know, it makes sense that you would throw it away, because how long will you simple minds love simplicity? He who has an ear, let him hear the book says. So you ain't got an ear. You don't understand what it's all about, you know? But back to the point, man, you know? Man.
Okay, what are we looking at right here? We're looking at the caduceus. And those are the two eyes, the two witnesses, positive and negative, Ida and Pagala, whatever. Okay, this is the wasp staff. And what does it represent? The caduceus are the same thing. They use the pine cone for the brain, and the staff is the spine. And there's the sperm. It's the same thing. The brain and the spine. It's the staff. The brain and the staff, which is the spine. That's what it all represents. And here's another picture.
The spine must be straightly aligned, because if not, then the energy cannot flow up the spine. It'd be like the equivalent of taking a garden hose and bending it, and the water getting stuck at one point, that would be the equivalent to the chakras becoming stuck at one point at an invertebrate spine.
White people have changed Yaqub's name to Jacob. So Jacob in the Bible is Yaqub, who created the white race. And that's why his verse is in Genesis, because Genesis in the dictionary means the origin or production or something.
Every one of you are on trial right now. Your heart's been weighed against a feather. You don't see it. You think you're safe. And then I'm going to send you people that are gods, who I'm going to tell them they can lead this world in their image. And however they have to clear it, do it. Because at the end of the day, that's what you did to my people. That's what you did to all of them. I brought all my people back. I bring the people you killed back to have revenge on fucking you, but this time I give them power, the dark matter mind. So now you, thank you for building up a world for my people. Thank you for giving us the technology. Thank you for wasting your time creating this world for us, because the sun and my people are going to wipe you away. And we're going to move into your mansions. We're going to move into your fucking colleges. We're going to move into every fucking thing you had. And then we're going to do what what you should have done. Teach, not preach, teach. But we're going to use all the fucking stuff that you built for us. Thank you.
I want you to try this experiment when you go to bed tonight. When it's dark in your room, you might have a little light in there, I don't know. Light from the TV, I don't know, from the clock. Anyway, I want you to eat a raw vegetable before you go to bed. Then take your hands and palm them over your eyes and close your eyes, and you will start seeing some lights appear. You have to look with your pupil, but you will start seeing some lights. And to me, that's like you're in the presence of the universe, of the Creator. Just try it and see. Close your eyes, palm your hands over your eyes, where it's like completely dark. Then see what happens. And then also see my video, The Holy Map. And there, if you have any questions for God, you can ask him during that time.
I'm winning, yeah, yeah, I'm winning.
Why?
I'm winning, yeah, yeah, I'm winning.
Why?
I'm winning, yeah, yeah, I'm winning.
Why?
Rich kid, paint me as a villain.
Why?
Don't be mad, cause I'm doing me better than you doing you. Don't be mad, cause I'm doing me better than you doing you. Don't be mad, cause I'm doing me better than you doing you. Better than you doing you, you.
Different color my passport, Instagram my stack load, hashtag my day wear, and your girl drank my daycare, and I'm born rich, life ain't fair.
Silver spoon, boom.
Ain't nobody sicker in my Fisker, boom, boom, ho, ain't nobody. Fiskers don't make noise when they start up, just so you know.
Top of the holy totem, rich forever, a million was not the quota. My father owned half the MoMA and did it with no diploma. Year off, got no rules, tripping off of them toadstools. More green than my Whole Foods, and I'm too fly, Jeff Goldblum. Got a glass house in the Palisades, that AKA White Hood, OKKK. Furniture custom, you shop at IKEA. So Maserati, you ripping the Kia. Spending this money, it's longer than Nia. Look like a Coppola, me and Sophia.
Who are you? Who are you?
I have been locked out of the Garden of Eden into this human form.